House Leader, third party.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker, and it is great to hear all three parties in the House commemorate International Women's Day, which we will celebrate tomorrow. But I think we also need to recognize the urgent need to continue to work together for a better world. A world where rape is not used as a weapon of war or power. A world where girls and young women are not excluded from educational opportunities because they are menstruating or have children of their own. A world where equal work receives equal pay. We have made strides in seeing more women elected. Now it's time for the next significant step, which is to see far more women in positions of leadership and to see the redefinition of leadership that fits the 21st century. For many leaders, being empowered to do things definitely differently will mean embodying a style of leadership that is kinder, more inclusive, and more empathetic. But make no mistake, kinder is not weaker. Indeed, there is nothing more powerful. I have seen the extraordinary strength of women who are rooted in kindness, the strength to face down the biggest issues of our time, the strength to stay at the table focused on the task at hand, the strength to listen and truly learn from people who have different perspectives, the strength to persist through all of that, often while simultaneously nurturing children and caring for elders, knowing you probably won't get the recognition or the pay that you deserve. That is true leadership. That level of strength is something I see every day in women, and I'm deeply inspired and encouraged by it. As women, we must not accept that it is enough to succeed in a man's world. It's time for us to rewrite the rules. Our collective goal should be a transformation to a world where everyone can truly thrive and meet their full potential. Women can help take us there.